Alright, hi, this is August White here with the Young Turks, and it is minutes before the police are supposed to raid Oshete Ayate camp. Right here, what you can see is the burning of the front entrance to the camp that has been here for over 6 months. This is where the security checkpoint was for water protectors and allies to come in and out for the last 6 months of this movement. It's now on fire. We've got police over this way waiting. Away from entering the camp. We've had teepees burning, ceremonially burning of structures, and the situation is probably going to get, I don't think anyone really knows what's going to happen right now, but tensions are high, and we've got a group of water protectors. We've got a group of water protectors down here by the camp that are remaining. They will be getting arrested if they stay there after 2 p.m., which is just minutes away. They're voicing their protest and actively standing there, willing to get arrested.
There's a generator in the fire. We need you back, please.
You must be on 1806. So there's a question about who will be getting arrested here that is media. We've known that the police here in Standing Rock have arrested media, which is unlawful, and journalists doing their jobs, and we're not sure if they're going to be doing it again today. It is now 2 o'clock, so we will see the police probably entering the camp just in minutes here. I'm hoping my phone doesn't die, the cord is sucking the battery out, but hopefully I can keep a charge enough to show you guys live what is happening. If not, tune in, we'll have a video coming out later most likely.
If you find me before you leave, and you give this back to me, then you can...
This is on. This amazing woman just gave me a charge and is saving the line. Thank you so much. What's your name?
Caitlin.
And what are you shooting for?
I'm independent, but right now I'm with Media Bridge Dispatch.
Great. Thank you for being here.
Yeah. Thank you.
Thank you for the charge. I'll try to get back to you. Government and the corporations are still oppressing these people like they've been doing for hundreds of years. Going down to the camp to see if someone will speak out about what exactly is going on, what their thoughts are.
Hello? doing what we want to do. Because we're here in a prayerful manner, you know. We are here, and we'll continue to be here. And if they want to squash this here, it's just going to pop up somewhere else, you know. Because we know in our hearts and in our minds that we are being mistreated, disrespected, and now forcefully being removed from this place that we love, Ochishashakowin. This place that many of us come to. With our homes. I thank everyone here for their support. And we need to get out of here now, so thank you for.
Thanks, Ray.
Yeah.
I feel honored to have met you in Seattle for that boon, for the divestment.
So, with people standing right here behind me, if we remain here for the next few minutes, we'll get arrested. So, I'm going to probably cross the barrier, get over the line, just because I know they'll be targeting journalists that don't have the proper credentials, according to them. Even though we're doing a job, we're allowing the public to see what's happening, which is necessary. But all of these people here behind me will be getting arrested if they remain here. And the cops should be coming in any minute now. It's past 2 o'clock. We've got people in their tents still, in the remaining that have decided they're going to stay inside and be forcibly removed. We've got people outside with goggles, with shields, with nothing. We've got press, we've got journalists. And looks like there will be a showdown soon, but the cops have not been entering yet. And it's past 2 p.m., so we're just waiting now, waiting to see what's going to happen. So the police should be coming in any minute, huh, Raymond?
Yes, they should be coming. They're making their way. They're gathering over there. They're starting to get their troops together. There's one thing I want to show you. You can see the troops up there. They're the ones that are fearful of our rights. They know we're right. Stood for, and we still stand for. Still parking on the graves of our ancestors, desecrating our ancestors. You can see over here the troops are starting to gather. It's after 2 o'clock now, and they're still talking. They've given us the opportunity to walk out of here. So hopefully, maybe after this, they'll open this highway up and people can come through here and witness for themselves. But we came here to try to prove to them that water is life, you know. We tried to inform them and let them know that what they're doing is destructive to our Mother Nature, Mother Earth and nature. So we're here because we know what's right. We're gonna be here in heart, moving somewhere else, but we're going to be everything that we learn from here, we take with us to the next stop, to the next stand, because we are proud of who we are. And I don't know what they're going to do, but we have a group of individuals down here that do not agree with their Warren County's tactics. And pray for them. Pray that they're treated with dignity and respect when they're taken to jail, because some of them have decided that they're going to stand and they're going to go to jail. Pray for them. Pray that they don't get hurt. Pray that they don't culture and their belief. Right now, it's a special day. It's a historical day in North Dakota, the United States, in the world. It's a historical day. This day is going to live in infamy. And we're glad to be a part of this, you know. I'm glad my grandfather, Mahina Vikas, led me here through his prayers and his strength, because that's who I pray with. I pray with my ancestors, Ma'om, Mudziya, Mahina Vikas, and all the Cheyenne spirits that are roaming over there at Bear Butte to protect all of us. So thank you. Thank you, August, for documenting this. Be careful. Please.
Still haven't entered the camp, which is a surprise because we were all expecting this to happen at 2 p.m. today. Just still waiting to see what's going to happen. Something just exploded in the fire over there. Just got a lot of media up here waiting on the highway 1806. Supposed safe zone where we won't get arrested, and water protectors and other individuals that want to stay in the camp down below.